Jews. Get up, Jew.
Get
up. Come on. Get up, Jew. Move it, Jew. Move it. Come on, Jew. Carry that cross. Get up.
Get up.
Get up. Move it. This is your cross. Move it. Get up, Jew. Jesus, King of the Jews. Get up. Thank you.
you owe them a debt so great that no one on earth could pay it, and then someone paid it. You may ask, what debt could be so great that no one on earth could pay it? That debt, the debt that each man and woman owes to God. Society demands full payment when a debt is owed. In the same way God demands full payment, His justice requires it. Society says some debts are so great the person must pay with his or her life. God has said only the sacrifice of a sinless life will pay our debt in full. No man or woman can live a sinless life. Therefore, no man or woman can pay the debt owed to God. But may I tell you that God had a plan. God sent His Son to become a man and to live a life that we could not live, to pay a price He did not owe. This man's name is Jesus Christ. He was born of a virgin, and He lived and died to pay your debts as well as mine. Only the sacrifice of Jesus' life is precious enough, is costly enough, is valuable enough in the eyes of our Creator to pay the debt in full. God required a full payment, and Jesus paid the payment through His blood. This is the saving love of God. What He has required, He has supplied. Hallelujah. To pay the debt of a sinful world, God gave His only Son. He gave His life, not ours. His payment, not ours. His glory, not ours. And even His blood, not ours. 3 days after His death, Jesus Christ rose from the dead with victory over death, hell, and the grave. He has ascended into heaven and now sits at the right hand of the Father. If you will believe in Him today, your sins and debts will be paid. So lift up your heads, because your redemption draweth nigh. Praise the Lord.
From hell, the storm was rolling.